हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज ओवर द काउंटर एक्सचेंज ऑफ इंडिया। दीज आर द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस वीडियो। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट इज ओवर द काउंटर एक्सचेंज। ओवर द काउंटर एक्सचेंज ऑफ इंडिया इज एन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक स्टॉक एक्सचेंज बेस्ड इन इंडिया दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ स्मॉल एंड मीडियम साइज फर्म एमिंग टू गिव एक्सेस टू ओवरसीज कैपिटल मार्केट्स। In over the counter exchange of India, there is no central place of exchange and all trading occur through electronic networks. It was incorporated in 1990 as a Section 25 of the Companies Act 1956 and is recognized as a stock exchange under Section 4 of the Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. The exchange was set up to help promoter in raising finance for new projects in a cost-effective manner and to provide investor with a transparent and efficient mode of trading. Over-the-counter exchange has introduced many new concepts to the Indian capital market, such as screen-based nationwide trading, sponsorship of companies, market making, and scriptless trading. Securities traded on a over-the-counter exchange are listed securities, permitted securities, and initiated debentures.
Next is why there was a need to establish over-the-counter exchange. Many small companies in India were finding it difficult to raise adequate capital through stock exchanges as the conditions stipulated by them were quite complex and rigid. Companies must have run for minimum 3 years, they must have earned profit, and the minimum capital requirement for listing was also quite high. So by promoting a new stock exchange with flexible conditions, the small and medium companies in India were able to raise sufficient capital. Then, the Fairwani Committee has identified the shortcoming of the existing stock exchange system and recommended establishment of over-the-counter exchange. And in addition to this, once the company enlarges their resources, they can list themselves in the regular stock exchanges.
Next is features of over-the-counter exchange. First is ringless and screen-based trading. Over-the-counter exchange was the first stock exchange to introduce automated screen-based trading in place of conventional trading found in other stock exchanges. Next is sponsorship. All the companies seeking the listing on Over-the-counter exchange of India have to approach one of the members of Over-the-counter exchange for acting as a sponsor to the issue. The sponsor makes a thorough appraisal of the project and ensures the quality of the companies. Next is transparency of transactions. Over-the-counter exchange system ensures that trades are done at the best prevailing quotation in the market. The confirmation slip or the trading document generated by the computers give the exact price at which the deal has been done and the brokerage charged. Next is listing of small and medium-sized companies. This I have already told that many small and medium-sized companies were not able to enter the capital market due to listing requirement of Securities Contract Regulation Act 1956. So, over-the-counter exchange provide an opportunity to these companies to enter the capital market as companies. Next is technology. Over-the-counter exchange of India uses computers and telecommunication to bring members or dealers together electronically, enabling them to trade with each another over the computers rather than on a trading floor in a single location. Next is nationwide listing. Over the counter exchange of India network is spread all over India through members, dealers, and representative office counters. Next is restriction for other stocks. Stocks and shares listed in other stock exchange will not be listed in over the counter exchange, and similarly, stocks listed in over-the-counter exchange will not be listed in any other stock exchange. Next is restriction for large companies. No company with the issued equity shares capital of more than 25 crores is permitted for listing in over-the-counter exchange. And the last is satellite facility. The satellite required for over-the-counter exchange for its operation is held with Press Trust of India. Next is participants of over-the-counter exchange. First is member and dealer who operate over-the-counter exchange counters, then companies which list their shares on over-the-counter exchange, then investors, then registrar who transfer and keep share certificates, then settlement bank, and the last is SEBI and government. There are many financial institutions which promote over-the-counter exchange. These are the following examples from them, so you can go through with these. Next topic is mechanism of over-the-counter exchange. The trading mechanism of over-the-counter exchange is quite different from other stock exchanges. It is based on created tradable document called counter receipt. Share certificate have to be converted to counter receipt to begin the trading. A sale confirmation slip is given to an investor when he sells the counter receipt and the transaction is completed. If an investor purchases a security at a public offer, he is issued a counter receipt which gives information about the investor as well as the company, share price, date of transaction, brokerage and total value of transaction. When an investor wishes to sell the security, he has to produce that counter receipt. Next is transfer process. In the transfer process, the transferor and the transferee sign separate transfer deeds. The registrar of the company match the two transfer documents and execute the deal. Over-the-counter exchange has a 5-day trading cycle. As the exchange does not allow short selling or forward buying, the deals are concluded at the time of confirmation. The transactions are fast and investor friendly with a single window request. It is computerized and it is traded through permanent counter receipt. It has an over-the-counter exchange index based at 100 since 23rd July 1993. Next is, what are the listing requirements in over-the-counter exchange? First is, once a company lists its securities in the market, it cannot delist for a minimum period of 3 years. Next is, there are certain norms to be fulfilled by the companies for sale of equity shares or any other securities under bought-out deal. Next is, 20% of the issued capital should be retained by the promoters for a period of not less than 3 years. And the last is, there should be 2 market makers as per the guidelines. Topic is advantages of over-the-counter exchange. These are the advantages to companies. First is, provides method of raising fund through capital market instrument which are priced fairly. In over-the-counter exchange, the company will be able to negotiate the issue price with the sponsor who will market the issue. Next is, saves unnecessary issue expenses on raising fund from capital markets. Next is, offer documents of companies will not be investigated by the SEBI. Such companies shall only file their offer document with SEBI and SEBI will communicate its comment to the issuer company and lead manager within 21 days. Next is, retains greater degree of management stability. And the last is, provides greater accessibility to large pool of captive investor base. Over-the-counter exchange will create a nationwide network where investors will be served who will form the captive investor base for companies.
Next is advantages of over-the-counter exchange to investor. First is, investment in stock becomes easier. Over-the-counter exchange wide network will bring the stock exchange accessible to everyone. Next is, provide greater confidence and fidelity of trade. Investor knows he is trading at the right market price as he can look up the prices displayed at each over-the-counter exchange. Next is, enables transaction to be completed quickly. Investor can settle the deal across the counter and the money or scrip proceeds from the deal will be settled in a matter of days. Provide definite liquidity to investors. The market making system will have two-way prices which are quoted regularly to provide sufficient opportunities for investors to exit. Now, a question must be arising in your mind, that what is two-way prices? A two-way prices indicate both the current bid price and the current ask price of the security during a trading day on an exchange. Fine. And the last is, investor may get a greater sense of security. Next is advantages to economy. Over-the-counter exchange will help spread the stock exchange operation geographically and integrate capital market investment in a forum. Next is, encourages closely held companies to go public. And the last is, encourages venture capital activities to boost entrepreneurs. Next is disadvantages of over-the-counter exchange. First is, there is a lack of clearing houses or exchange, which results in increased credit or default risk associated with each over-the-counter exchange contract. Next is, precise nature of risk and scope is unknown to regulators, which lead to increased systematic risk. Next is lack of transparency. And the last is, speculative nature of transaction causes market integrity issues. So this was all about over-the-counter exchange. Thank you for watching.